So does that make sense, Soka?
No. No, it does. I've never heard that. That is so interesting.
It's counterintuitive, and I know I've done it. It works. I've given it to my clients, and they say the same thing that you do. Like, what? You want me to do what?
Did you push record?
Thanks so much for tuning into our second act with Paige and Silka.
For your second act of life. Hey there, Silka.
Hello, Paige. Paige, today I just want to tell you how grateful I am that we're doing the show together.
Thank you, Silka. That makes me feel so good inside.
Well, at this time of year, of course, and this video will live for a long time and be valid every day of the year, because one of the articles I ran across, lots is written on this, how much happier we are if we practice gratitude versus focusing on, you know, what's wrong or what we're missing. And, you know, again, the times we're in right now, it can be difficult to find gratitude in a lot of things that people are going through. But what it affects, and I thought this was interesting. I mean, it's kind of, you know, makes sense, it's intuitive, but how gratitude and practicing gratitude really changes and improves and builds your relationships. And I thought that'd be a terrific topic to talk about, especially now. So talk to me about that. How does gratitude really affect our relationships?
It's huge. It's gigantic. And you're right. It's a great topic that you came up with, Soka. So, you know, so many times when we're in a relationship, especially if we've been in it for a while, it's the little things that really drive us crazy about what someone does. And then that gets blown up with the next thing that they do. And then the next thing. And when you're in a pandemic, that really blows everything up. So then the spiral starts about everything the other person hasn't done or what they've done that's caused issues, and it just goes and goes and goes. And everybody goes in that place several times in a relationship. However, there is some positive things that you can do about being grateful, and having gratefulness does create happiness in so many ways. So one of the big things, I've done it for myself, I've given it to my clients, is I've had my clients, no matter what, for 40 days, you get a journal, and each day, I'll explain it as best I can. Each day, you're going to write down, of course, the things that you're grateful for in your partner. However, the way you're going to do it is, let's just say your partner doesn't pick up their clothes or clean the dishes or whatever. I'm just giving a small example. You're actually going to write down in your journal, I am so grateful so-and-so did not pick up his clothes or did not do the dishes. And it might feel counterintuitive, but what you'll start to see, you're going to write down all the things that bug the shit out of you, but you're going to put it in a sentence that you're grateful for it. And you're going to do it every day, and you're going to start to notice that those things that bother you don't anymore. And you're going to start to notice that your sentences will change to other things that bother you. And then that will lessen. And then you'll start to shift to the things that you truly are grateful for. So does that make sense, Soka?
No. No, it does. I've never heard that. That is so interesting.
It's counterintuitive. Yeah. And I know I've done it. It works. I've given it to my clients, and they say the same thing that you do. Like, what? You want me to do what? And I'm always like, yes, I want you to do this, because it's amazing what will happen when you do it. So just give it some time. But yes, all the things that bug the crap out of you, that's what you're going to write down, all the things that you're grateful for. And believe me, if you're using a pen in your journal, you'll notice that the pen is just really heavy writing. Or if you're using a pencil, the pencil point might break. That's okay. Each day you do this, there will be less and less charge to it. And what you'll find is it filters out all the stuff that really is not important. And it really gets down to the stuff that is important that maybe you can speak to your partner about. And then that shifts in your writing as to, wow, what I really am grateful for. Now, remember, if you're in a relationship that it's already on the outs, this will help you to detach from that relationship and leave it in a real, you know, grateful manner for everything that you learned. So does that piece make sense, Silka?
It does. And it's what you're describing also is something that, you know, this is something how to work on yourself to shift your mindset, which is so important, from a state of frustration, lack or whatever, to a state of gratitude, and then change your attitude. One thing that I also read in this article, and we'll link to it because it actually has a bunch of gratitude studies that showed some really interesting results. But it's that it's not just, and I'm shifting a little bit here, but it's not just the thought that counts, that if you really want to affect somebody else, it's expressing gratitude and how, you know, how that affects somebody and how you express it, that can be, you know, day and night, or change day and night the direction of where you're going, not just in romantic relationships, but everyday relationships. Talk to me about that a little bit.
Absolutely. And, you know, doing this writing exercise, if you're in a place where you're nowhere near gratitude, it will get you in the place where you start to voice things. Because you can say something, but if you don't really feel it, the other person's going to know that you're not really grateful. So sometimes you have to go to the place to kind of filter out the things that have really gotten on your nerves to get to the place of gratitude. And, you know, it's also important when we talk about relationships, the biggest, most important relationship, and I know I've said this forever if you've been our followers, is the one with yourself. So if you're going through a hard time for whatever it is personally while you're in a relationship, but it's about maybe you have health issues or injuries or career or whatever it might be, start to also write down, you know, what you're grateful for. I'm grateful that I just lost my job. I'm grateful that I have a really painful injury, because you'll start to weed that out and you'll start to find things that you are grateful for. And when it starts within here and you start to feel better, then you can always, you know, extend that to other people that are around you as well.
It's interesting because a lot of times I've heard that, you know, when you say, well, it's so hard to find something to be grateful for. So now you're not telling people to find things to be grateful for, but just write down, you know, this counterintuitive thinking. Very interesting. I'll look forward to the comments on this to see what other
people. Oh, I'm sure, but I'm going to promise you, if you do it and you stick with it, and that's the thing, you know, it's like anything. People will start to do something and go, oh, I feel better, so I'm going to stop it. Don't do that. Commit to it from the beginning to the end, because there's some miraculous things that can happen within yourself and within the relationship and with the other person as well.
Yeah. The other thing that really spoke to me, another study, is when you actually first starting relationships, that when you do thank people or show gratitude and show appreciation, that there's more motivation to actually build a relationship or stay in that relationship. I mean, it's so obvious, yet we don't really think about that, I don't think.
No, it's funny you should just say that, because I just had a conversation with my husband two nights ago and I said, do you realize how important thank you is? It's simple, but it's so important. And what I have seen through the years, if you grew up in a family where you didn't really get a lot, so you were grateful for any little thing you got and you were just thank you, it comes more naturally. If you have grown up in a family where you were given everything, you were enabled, and there wasn't any thank you, and most of the time what I see is a person that comes from that kind of family hooks up with the person who was always grateful, and this person over here has to learn to be grateful and thank you for the things that the other one does. For instance, if somebody goes to the grocery store, hey, thanks for doing that. Thanks for cleaning out the kitty litter or picking up the medication or whatever it is. It might seem so small, but it's so big because you're just honoring and respecting that you're noticing, paying attention to what somebody else is doing. And ultimately, we all want people to at least know, hey, do you see what I'm doing over here? We don't need constant, you know, flares of that, but start to just say thank you, and it will make a huge, gigantic, enormous difference.
Yeah. Well, and I want to add to that is the comments that we get. You know, we get tons, hundreds, thousands of comments. And there are always those handful that I am so appreciative for when there's those genuine, I want to thank you and Paige for what, for this topic. My God, you made the difference in my life. This was just the, when I can't tell you enough how much that means to keep us going.
Oh, yes. And you know, and you get a lot of the other kinds too.
And you, you know, you do. It's a perfect example of when you, when somebody gets that kind of recognition and thank you, it keeps them going, wanting to do more. And in this case, in this video, investing in the relationship. There was some aha stuff in there for me reading this. And I just thought it was a terrific topic to discuss, not only just in our environment, but, you know, of course, Thanksgiving is coming up, but this is a topic for, you know, every day. Paige, what else would you like to add?
You know, I would just like to add, as a country, we've really gotten away from honoring and respecting each other. And we've gotten so focused on our own needs, and we need this, and we have to have this, and we're going to get angry because we're not going to get it. We've gone so far to the other side of the spectrum that we need to start to pull ourselves back in to be more balanced. And just if the only thing you can do every day is say thank you, then say thank you. And it doesn't always have to be with your intimate partner. It can be with the person at the grocery store. It can be someone down at who is fixing your car. Whatever it might be, just thank you. We have to start getting back to honoring each other, coming together with each other globally, statewide, community-wise, with your intimate relationships, and within yourself. Thanking yourself for, wow, this is the things that I did today. This is what I'm proud of myself for today. And I'm grateful because I was even here today.
That I agree with you 100%, Paige. And to those of you watching, we thank you for watching, and we really, really mean it.
Very deeply, because that's what keeps us going. When we know, like Silk had said, that we're doing something that's helpful, that's helping to change your life in a meaningful, fulfilling, positive way, that's the fulfillment that drives us.
Exactly. And Paige, on that note, we will see you next time on our second act with Paige and Silka.
For your second act of life.
Bye-bye.
Thank you.
Thanks so much for watching. We really appreciate it. So if there's a topic that you'd like to have us cover, please visit our website, secondact.tv. We have a little suggestion box on the upper right-hand corner of our site. Just click on that, send us an email. We'd love to hear from you. See you next time.